Feel free to interrupt me anytime you want. So I'm Keto Miner, or Maiko for those who don't know me. I'm the technical guy behind the Nodal box. You can screenshot the PGP keys for future reference. So the box is only one part of what we are doing. We are also working on hosted payment servers and Lightning servers. I would like to talk about a few challenges we met while doing the hosted stuff and how we are trying to solve it, and also interact with you as how you would like to see it solved. So just a short history. I started electronics and internet before it was cool. My first computer was pen and paper, then moved to small and bigger and bigger programmable things, microcontrollers, smart cards, and stuff like that. Went a little through corporate IT, like HR and financial systems, and then went full-time building big networks. I work for the French television as my day job. And Bitcoin kind of combines all my interests. It's hardware, software, security, cryptography, infrastructure, so it's probably the first thing where I don't get bored when I do something about it. Brief history of the Nodal. I started 110k blocks ago building full nodes for my own use. Because I bought Andreas' book and I needed some platform to run BitcoinD and play with Bitcoin CLI. It ran fine on a Raspberry Pi Zero back in the time. It synced in 8 days. A year later, the device was dead, so I started iterating on other hardware to find something which synchronizes in a reasonable time, and ended up using the not ideal, but I learned that after ROG64 and an SSD. And fast forward to today, we have almost 1% of the Lightning network running on a single Nodal box. There is still a lot of work to do. It's a very rough product. We are trying to listen to our customers. They want to run Electrum with the Nodal box. For that, we need an Electrum server. EPS is far from ideal. Electrum X is made by a shitcoiner, and we are switching currently to Electr-S, which will be the first officially running Electrum server on the Nodal. There is lots of cleanup, refactoring, code signing, and stuff like that to do. We can talk about that outside if you're interested. Integrate VPNs. Currently, we are using Zero Tier as a not supported solution because it's a third-party service and you need to subscribe to the website to use it. More Tor, including the possibility to run the Nodal as a Tor relay. And the ICOs, which are the initial channel opening services. Soon, when you buy the box, it will be coming automatically with an option to open a channel to you, so you can start receiving payments without the burden of opening channels. So now I want to go online business. How do I do to accept Lightning payments? The easy solution is obviously to go for custodial. We don't want that. The bad solution is to buy another box and to open it on the internet. Everyone will know your IP address. You will get DDoSed and your life will be a nightmare. So the two solutions I'd like to explore is using a hosted payment server and a VPN for the Lightning part to your own node. So the Lightning part runs non-custodial on your node at home or in your business, and the payment services on the internet on some hosting platform, which is designed to be accessed by many clients and has proper protections. Or to use a semi-custodial solution in which you rent a Lightning instance, but this Lightning instance is still dedicated to you and not shared in a database with other customers. So the pros and cons of the of the VPN solution, or just simply opening the Lightning API of your node and connecting from BTC Pay to your Lightning API. It highly depends on the stability of your network connection. So when your internet goes down, you don't have Lightning anymore on your store. It's probably acceptable. You still can get on-chain payments, and BTC Pay is smart enough to try to connect to the Lightning node, and if it doesn't reply, it will only propose on-chain. You can use many different VPN protocols. Zero tier is one, as I mentioned. Pretono is a nice one. Or you can just use Tor, why not? But if you are renting your payment processor instance on some shared or some big platform server, you will probably not be able to install the VPN software on it. So you need something like a VPS, which you own, and you set up your VPN yourself. The main issue is really the stability of the connection, and some VPNs, assuming we can call Tor a VPN, can be tricky for the stability and uptime perspective. Hosting LND in a server environment, definitely not on a VPS, because not your metal, not your server, not your server, not your keys. Bugs in virtualization software are not happening very often, but when they do, they hurt pretty bad. Amazon is using Xen for the virtual servers. A few years ago, they had to patch all the platform because there was a privilege escalation which allowed people to escape from the virtual machine. So you can always assume that a neighbor on the same physical server can enter in your virtual machine from another virtual machine if a bug is found. Dedicated can quickly become expensive. You can, of course, rent a full redundant server and or cluster of servers and run your stuff on it. It will cost you a few hundred to a few thousand dollars per month, probably. So what we are trying to do is go to something which is between the VPS and the big cluster of servers. So obviously, people who have administrative access to the physical machine can steal your secrets. That you can't do anything against that. Encryption of the hard drive only works when the server is off. As long as the server is on, the root administrator of the server has access to the unencrypted contents. So the idea is you get a VPS on a server you get a virtual machine on the server you own, running your own LND with all the other services shared. Like BTC Pay doesn't have to be dedicated because it doesn't contain any secrets. Bitcoin D doesn't have to be dedicated because it's used only for reading the blocks by BTC Pay. And the process of initializing your Lightning node is done by yourself, so you are the only person who will see the seed, assuming there is no administrator sitting in front of the physical machine and looking at the screen at the moment you are doing it. This is how it looks. This is our first point of presence in Paris. It's actually full ISP in three rack units. On top you have a BGP router. In the middle there is a simple switch, and in the bottom there is a one rack unit with two full servers inside. It can also be hosted on premises. For example, if you are a big business and you want your own payment server and host it in your data center or even in your network cabinet, it's very low power, so it can fit in the network cabinet. You can just use that in your business, or you can put it in any data center, or you can just rent it from us. We can do geo-redundancy because BTC Pay is running on top of a Galera cluster. For those who know, it's MySQL in a clustered version. There are banks actually running on Galera with a worldwide geosynchronous cluster, meaning any transaction written by any node in the world is replicated to all the nodes and is considered written after all the nodes acknowledge the transaction. And yeah, we can run as many LNDs and C-Lightnings as we want in LXC containers on the same box. For simplicity, it's running Proxmox VE, which is based on KVM and LXD. And we are running so this. It's slightly heavier than a Docker container, but it's lighter than a full virtual machine. And we do cross backups between the two nodes inside the rack. It has dual power, dual CPU, dual RAM, dual everything. So basically we can lose half of the rack and it's still running. We can scale that up in a bigger server. Now you can easily buy like a two rack unit server with four independent units inside, and we can also deploy something like this. And so this infrastructure I've shown before is running the ISP, which we called AS Bitcoin. So for an AS on the internet is like the smallest unit which you can call an ISP. It's an autonomous system. It has a number. In this case, it's 422.75. And so that's make you an ISP on the internet. The challenges behind this are mostly related to the exhaustion of the IPv4 address space. I don't know if it's your experience, but I noticed that running multiple Lightning nodes behind a single IPv4, even with separate ports, obviously, Lightning doesn't like that. One of the nodes is privileged compared to the others, and the others are difficult to access. I can't explain it. I believe it's just because it's like really expecting to be running on the default port, and as soon as you drop this requirement, something goes wrong. Clearly, in the Bitcoin world, we are 20 years behind on IPv6. No one really cares about it. Most of the products are not compatible, like Lightning wallets, for example. Zap doesn't understand what an IPv6 is. Joule can be torn to accept it if you trick it, but it's not so easy. IPv4 are very expensive. To get a block of 1,000 IPv4s in Europe, you have to spend €3,000 the first year. In the United States, you just can't. There are no IPv4 left. Tor is a good way to run Lightning without an IPv4 because it works very well on onion addresses. It's publicly reachable with air quotes because you have less liquidity on the Tor Lightning than on the ClearNet Lightning, even if this is really changing now and more we don't see any big difference. For example, the guys of TFTC moved their node from ClearNet to Tor and they didn't experience any loss of channels by doing it. So clearly to avoid this IPv4 problem, if you have your LND on premises, you already have an IP address, so just use that for your Lightning node and connect to a shared payment server. The other things I already mentioned. Also running a VPN on your Lightning node is cool because you can remote from your phone. I'm using Zap on my phone with zero tier and my node is at home, so it works very well. Paid for coffee 5 times today already. But actually, is the problem really technical? Maybe going back to custodial for the normal merchants is the right way to go, because what we experience is like people buy a Lightning instance or Lightning node, they open a channel and they ask, okay, I've opened the channel, why can't I receive payments? That's a natural question. So maybe after all, what is missing here is not a good technical solution, but a good human solution to curate the channels for people, for merchants. And that's probably the last So, any questions? Okay, so the question is on the let's say corporate server version, how many nines of uptime we can promise? As long as you provide two separate sources of energy, we are probably at 5 nines. So the question is, what is the demand for the data center and the server stuff? Currently, clearly, it's zero. We just want to be ready for the day someone will ask for it. and we are actually dogfooding it by providing this service to small shops which don't want to buy a box, but want to try Lightning, and we are just renting like. We have a shared drag between many customers.
Could you like provide Lightning services for existing payment providers or something?
Yeah, or for bars or for physical shops.
Maybe I missed it, but can you just talk around kind of pricing models you've been thinking about and maybe the levels?
So pricing, pricing for what we call the cloud stuff, which is like shared L&D on our own racks. It will be like a monthly fee. I don't have a price to tell yet because it's too early. But it will be reasonable compared to something like BTC Pay is doing on Luna node, except it will have full redundancy. And backups, which they don't have. And for the rack, you can probably compare it to some network appliance type business, like you get a support contract and then you renew it for 20% of the value of the hardware every year. That's the basic idea. Yes?
Do you know if some of those Lightning applications are planning to support Lightning?
Sorry?
Do you know if some of those Lightning applications are planning to support IPv6
or not? So the question is, do I know about applications which support IPv6 on Lightning? Currently, I don't think of any that does it right. It's that stupid. The problem is only parsing the IP and recognizing it as a valid IP. And also the fact that in general you have to always give the port. And as you know, an IPv6 is using colons and the ports too. So you have to put the address part in brackets. And so it's like refused by default because brackets are not a valid number.
Lightning implementations proper do support it, right?
Yeah. Lightning itself supports. It's only the client apps that don't really support it. Also, there's a giveaway of one node going on. I think Jeff will be publicizing the link. It's a lottery. You have to pay 15,000 satoshis in Lightning, and the result will be announced tomorrow. And we have a few to sell as well. Any more questions? Thank you.